between. We are the Arson Brothers, and I, A.B. Size, a Scrooge, a humbug, a non-holiday lover, am here to be taken on a Christmas walk of Christmas food delights by my holiday cheer brothers, and this is North Pole Eats! Tonight, we will feast upon the finest foods from some of our favorite Christmas movies. The food, the drink, the cheer will be brought, and we'll see how we like it. I don't know. I mean, some might be good, some might be bad, but all of it will be exciting. So first up, we're going to start with the drinks.
Woo.
All right, for the drinks, we have two iconic Christmas drinks. First off, from the Polar Express, we have some delicious hot chocolate.
Woo.
Secondly, from Christmas Vacation, we don't have any moose mugs to drink it out of.
Man.
But we've got some eggnog. Clark Griswold's favorite.
Boo.
So, Scott, since the chocolate's right there in front of you, why don't you pour us out some hot cocoa?
I shall. A scoop of whipped cream on top and a few mini marshmallows.
We have all the accompanying delights for this chocolate here.
I'll tell you what, I'll pour you.
Don't mellow my marshmallows.
That was just too mellow.
All right. This pour action here. Straight from the arson pitcher. This may be the most wholesome thing that's ever been in the arson pitcher.
Easily.
Yeah. Possible.
Is that everybody?
I think everybody's got a pour. And dress your nogs up or your chocolates up here, guys.
Marshmallows.
Mmm.
Marshmallows,
anybody? It's lukewarm. It's lukewarm.
Give me a shot.
Yeah,
dude.
Yeah.
It's
good.
Yeah, Matt made this. Use a little milk in there. Got it nice and thick and delicious.
Oh, yeah.
Very,
this is going to be a lot better than this one. This one's going to be so gross. This one looks amazing.
It's so thick. White Mike slid into its DMs.
Ugh.
Look. All right. Everybody ready?
Yep.
Well, cheers.
Cheers.
To the Polar Express. To Tom Hanks.
Those dead eyes.
Oh,
that's chocolatey.
It's good.
Mm.
Rich.
Mm.
Delicious.
Yeah.
Like Christmas of yore.
Mm. Mm.
Ah, yeah.
I'd take a ride on a train for this.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. Yep.
That's delicious.
Mm-hmm. I'd be stared at with dead animation eyes.
That would happen.
Mm. Those marshmallows at the end.
Mm. Yeah.
Soaking up that chocolate.
Oh, they're amazing. They're getting full, expanding with chocolate.
Mm.
Let me tell you, this won't be our last endeavor with marshmallows tonight.
Or with supplement amounts of elf food known as sugar.
Yeah?
That was good. Mm.
That was very good.
Oh, yeah.
Very good.
Mm. Wonderful. It's Christmas time.
It can only get better, right?
Yeah,
we can only get something.
Past this. This was
so
delicious. This is, honestly, I gotta be honest. That was really good.
The ending.
All right. Delicious chocolate from a iconic yet somewhat creepy kids movie,
yes.
The Polar Express.
It's very creepy. It takes a lot to make Tom Hanks creepy.
It really does. Tom Hanks has never been creepy a day in his life until that movie.
Moving on.
All right, now to our next iconic Christmas drink, Clark Griswold's favorite, eggnog.
Oh, boy.
Now, this is a divisive drink amongst the Arson Brothers. There's some here that love it, and there's some here that hate it.
I've actually never had it, so.
Whoa,
it's not that
virgin.
Yeah.
Eggnog virgin.
What if he just pukes?
He's got a,
it's disgusting.
He's got a,
I'm going to sip this, by the way.
Break it open.
All right, crack that open, Stevie. Crack that nog.
Lord, yeah. Lord knows we want it.
If you're going to make an arson video, you got to crack a few egg nogs.
The hot chocolate was really good.
It was your best Clark there, Jeff.
Yeah. Well,
where's the Tylenol?
I'm just giving the crazy Clark eyes. Oh, thank you, sir. Nice and thick, Stevie.
Nice. That's and what thick. She
said. It's thick looking.
Who wants this?
Here, we'll pass
who did down. This? Right. Who did
here, this? Somebody send that down to the table there.
Smells really good, actually.
Ah. Oh.
Smells.
Would have to disagree.
Yeah.
Smells like Christmas.
Oh, it does. Yeah. It's like those candles at Bath and Body.
I'm trying to go an open mind here. Every year, I'll try eggnog. You got maple syrup?
It's maple syrup. Can I have some maple syrup?
It's not quite maple syrup.
Take a little drop of maple syrup.
I guess you should, Clark Griswold, like a little maple syrup in hand.
Well, Cousin Eddie,
a little bit of that. Might not even finish it.
A little SoCo eggnog. Is that a classic staple of Christmas time.
Yeah, that's true. I feel like that's what was being drank in the Griswold home. I mean, it's known seemingly that alcohol was certainly in their nog because during the frantic, he was, you know.
Yeah, and Cousin Eddie would probably spiked it.
Oh, for sure. Even if it wasn't. Yeah.
Would you like some more
eggnog? Like the smell? Do you like the smell, Scott?
Nope. I'll be able to have it whenever I leave next month.
All right.
This is the grossest.
All right.
Ever. To the Griswolds.
To the Griswolds.
Nog's up.
Okay. It's not like terrible and grossing me out, but it's not something I would ever.
That tastes like Christmas.
That is rich, creamy deliciousness.
That tastes like Christmas.
I've got to say, I've been a fan of eggnog since I was a wee lad. Yeah. I can remember going to the grocery store.
No, it takes a second.
And bringing home a carboys.
So good. It's a chug.
It's an instant.
I don't hate it. The maple syrup you put in was really good. The maple syrup.
No, I took a sip there. You don't like it either?
Dang. Not a huge fan.
It's like, it's good, but like,
it's
you know,
not terrible.
You can't have too much of it. It's a little heavy.
Yeah, you couldn't drink a whole jug of it.
No.
I mean, you could.
You can't drink it. You can't drink a little bit in a cup. What do you mean?
All right. There's one other drink that we have prepared for tonight.
Ooh.
But we're going to save it for later. And that's a full 2 liters of Coca-Cola Classic.
Ooh, Buddy the Elf's Coke Chug Challenge.
Chugged by Buddy the Elf in Elf.
I'm calling it now. I feel like Ninja's got that.
Yeah, just lock it down.
We're going to spike Ninja's sugar.
What a rush.
This might be the end of their sugar intake tonight, but Ninja's in particular.
This will be the end of Ninja as you know him.
Something to look forward to.
Right. But stay tuned. Next up, the appetizers.
Oh boy,
are they appetizing.
Really?
All right, we are back for the appetizer portion of North Pole Eats. Mm-mm-mm. And I feel like these appetizers are thicker than peanut butter.
They are. Because.
Or pea soup.
Indeed.
That's right. Just like the fog in Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, we have... You eat what you like, I'll eat what I like.
You gone.
Peanut butter and pea soup.
Oh, boy.
This is the guy. You can see the guys up front fixing their plates. Us guys back here in the back already have ours together. Some good big old bowl of pea soup there. Some thick peanut butter. And you know what? Last year, about this time, we had an encounter with the guy whose cousin was in this movie.
That's true. His cousin was in Rudolph.
His cousin was starred in the original Rudolph special. You may know his cousin as the Bumble. But for this Christmas special, we want to bring back our friend from last year, the Yeti!
The Yeti!
Oh, there is a Yeti.
Welcome back, friend.
Welcome back. Yeti.
You weren't just drunk?
No, apparently I was not hallucinating Yetis. There was a real Yeti. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeti, are you excited about pea soup and peanut butter?
All right.
Somebody fix this Yeti a plate up there.
I don't think you're ready for this Yeti.
Smell Yeti?
Now, I saw A.B. Matt over there giving his little mix, so let's I'm going to do the mix.
Oh, yeah.
Little combo.
Combo layout.
It's a... so thick it's hard to even mix.
It really is.
It's oh, you mix it? Mix. Oh my god.
Hey, give it a mix there.
Oh, okay.
Give it a mix.
Peanut butter piece. Kind of like a pad thai soup, maybe.
You know, it really actually may be. So.
All right. You guys ready to dig in?
Let's do it.
Yep.
Forks up. Okay. All right.
It's really not. It's really not that bad.
No, I've got to be honest. I actually kind
of
like it.
I've got a little bit of piece of paper that I didn't mix.
I'm waiting for a second bite.
Guys, you're right. It does have a little bit of like the pad thai.
It's pretty good.
No, I would eat pretty gross.
Again.
Steve, you're already giving it the gross rating.
I don't hate it.
I don't either.
It's okay.
I finished my plate.
I'm almost there.
Clean plate club. Pad thai piece of soup. Yeah, put a little sriracha. Put a little sriracha on that.
Oh, clean plate club.
Yeti loved it. Yeti's a hungry man. He's usually eating reindeer and elves. Today he's eating pea soup.
I'm glad he's not eating us.
No, I'm glad he's not here to eat us.
I'm going
to
use a marshmallow as a palate cleanser.
Jeff, man, Matt, Ninja, all join the clean plate club on the...
I like it enough that I'm like raking up.
It's really not that
it's
bad.
Actually
the combo.
Kind of thing that works.
Anybody want seconds?
I don't know about that. Let's not push the
experience.
They didn't like it.
Got a lot of stuff left.
They didn't like it.
I didn't hate it.
We got a lot of stuff left to eat. Well, yeah, well. Huh. So, Steve, are you the only hater?
I didn't love it.
We got
Brandon in the Clean Plate Club.
Okay.
Steve and Scott the Outlaw. Yeah. Well, I didn't finish mine either, but not because I didn't like it, just because I got a lot of food to eat. So, the appetizers.
Pretty appetizing.
Somewhat appetizing, except for these guys.
More so than expected, at least.
Yeah,
at least
better than I planned it to be.
We have a lot of pieces.
I literally expected this to be the worst thing of the night. So
really.
When I really looked down and looked at it, I was, and I mean, I was right. It's
just not appetizing to look at.
No,
it's very
looks like rough. At best, some sort of baby food. At worst, some sort of baby
excrement.
Poo.
Yeah, you know how when you get your Blizzard at Dairy Queen, they hold it upside down. I feel like well, it probably dropped, but I didn't think it was going to drop.
But it's close.
Yeah, it's pretty thick. All right, well, we've got the appetizers out of the way. Let's move on to the side dishes.
Ooh, here we go.
There's been some exciting Christmas side dishes.
There we go. They are exciting, actually.
All right.
I'm looking right at them.
We're breaking out the little sauce for the side dish. Side dish time.
Ooh.
And we have the side dishes from two iconic Christmas films. First off, we have the Hoo Hash from the original Grinch Stole Christmas.
Ooh.
And beside our Hoo Hash, we have movie-specific mac and cheese.
That's right.
That's right. Stouffer's cooked in the microwave, just like Kevin McAllister does in the original Home Alone. So, I'm going to dig into our sides here. This may be the simplest of all the meals we have so far.
Simplest, yet the greatest possible.
Mm.
Oh. Oh, Hoo Hash.
Macaroni.
Oh, ooh. That hash, guys.
The onions definitely help. Are wonderful.
That hash.
That's some hot hash.
Mac and cheese is good as well.
It is hot.
The hash is right out the griddle, so.
Man, we did corned beef hash, added an onion.
Yeah. We don't know what's in real Hoo Hash, but in Arson Hoo Hash, it's corned beef hash, add an onion.
And it's very good.
It's delicious.
And I just went ahead and mixed it all together.
I was going to say, what happens when you mix a bite?
It's
very good. I feel like that's going to be good.
This would be like if Kevin McAllister went to Hoo Hash.
Mix them together.
Oh, man. Yes.
I just tried that, yeah.
The mix? I like the mix.
Mixing the rest of my whole plate here.
This is delicious, y'all. Seriously.
Yeah, this is bombs. The onions, I've never done the onions.
Stevie, you've been the odd man out so far.
Oh, this is delicious. This is amazing. I can't even talk, actually.
Braden?
Good.
No complaints on the Hoo Hash macaroni and cheese? Maybe the only segment of today's show. It's not going to have any complaints.
So if you're looking for... those side dishes for your Christmas dinner. Think about Hoo Hash and Stouffer's mac and cheese because it's quite popular.
In the microwave.
And maybe even mix them together.
I think that's the only way to go.
Mm. Maybe I'll bring this to Christmas dinner.
Yeah.
Please.
Please do.
Please do.
Mixed. That was excellent. Excellent. Excellent.
Yeah, I'm going full clean plate club on this one. Too good.
Too good.
Too good.
Plate liquor. I got close. tap out. That was really good.
Wrap some eggs with this.
Oh, yeah. Long
Friday.
Woo! Yeah.
That would have been amazing. Oh, do some bacon even.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Damn.
Make your tongue lap your brains out.
Sausage, I mean, gravy and biscuit?
Oh,
wow.
Baby.
All right.
Full on breakfast with this. We're ready to go.
Side dishes was a hit. We're a hit. Next up, we're going to the main course.
Woo!
And it's time for our main courses.
Main event.
And for the main course, first off, we've got the cheese pizza.
Oh, Little Nero's.
Come along, Little Angelo's.
Angelo's got kind of looks
keep
like
the
little
change,
Nero.
You filthy animal.
Oh.
It kind of looks like it. Box.
Good flop.
Little flopper.
One bite, everybody knows the rules. Oh, you guys hate that guy.
I hate that guy.
And the tostada from Bad Santa. And Scott and Andrew looks like they just have bologna and bread. That's not a tostada.
You're
going to
get the
sauce. Making a tostada.
Fried bologna, bread. Fried bologna, white.
Do you roll it up like a burrito?
No, you just eat it like a tostada.
Oh.
Right into it. It's not a sandwich. It's a tostada.
Must eat it flat.
A favorite of
Billy. So the bread's like a cracker.
It's all about presentation.
Yeah. So what do you guys want to dive into first? Let's start with tostada?
Tostada.
Tostada.
There we go.
Let's do it. It's for you, Thornton.
Oh.
Three. Whoa.
Huh. All
right. Oh, my God.
What have we just discovered?
I think we've discovered we like bad food.
I actually don't enjoy that one as much.
No?
No, I don't like the salsa with the bologna.
It's pretty solid.
I like it.
Steve and I are just going to be opposite on everything.
I'm finishing it out.
I gotta say, I like this.
Done.
Get another bite.
I think I can put some hot sauce on this.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
No, I like that one.
It's solid.
Yeah. But just, bologna you need is either mustard or mayonnaise, not salsa.
Well, I like that.
Why not both?
It is strange, though. Yeah. It's very strange, but
it is.
I dug it though. But it wasn't bad.
Like I wouldn't eat that on the rag, but
if I was like dirt poor, yes.
Oh yeah, that'd be a delicacy.
Yeah. Brad, what do you think about it?
I'm pretty close, so
not too bad actually.
Not too bad. All right.
I like it.
I'm not a fan.
Ninja?
I liked it.
Yeah.
Ninja finishes out. So.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. I think it's like a. I would say it's like a white trash delicacy.
Yeah,
it is. That's probably the best way to describe.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, little. White trash, Hispanic, Mexican.
Trash mix.
Nice. Jamie Noble eats these on the road all the time.
Our brother's trash mix not coming up.
Now, this right here.
Little Nero's, Little Angelo's.
All right.
Oh, no, that's a cheese pizza.
All right.
Mamma mia.
Of all the local pizza joints we had, I was like Angelo's for Little Nero's, I feel like.
Yeah.
Did you get the, for us here in Prince of West Virginia, there was only one choice to get the as close as we thought we could to Little Nero's, and that was certainly
my second thought was Slice.
Yeah, Slice was a little too fancy.
Yeah, it was too fancy for Little Nero.
Yeah, Dave Portnoy going to Little Caesars. Should have went to Angelo's.
That's right.
Oh, he did.
You go to Angelo's?
Yeah, in part two.
Oh, I didn't
see. Did he?
He did. I watched it today. All
right, but yeah.
That's even closer, though.
Angelo's is amazing.
Mm-hmm. Let's go.
I would say Geno's would probably be the second best choice.
Geno's would be.
We're getting one.
Where's Geno's?
Where?
Somebody said we're getting the Geno's. Where Burger Boy used to be.
Yeah. Oh, wow. I think there's one in Athens still, right?
There is, and Burrow.
That building's cursed.
Yeah.
It is.
Don't go there.
All right, we had a question in each on the ones in Blue Well. We got eight from that.
We did?
Yeah, okay.
Cursed!
I still feel Angelo's is more, more home alone.
Yeah, I agree. Mm-hmm. Look at that box. It's close.
Yeah, it's real close. The delivery guy wouldn't recreate the same with this.
The delivery guy was
no. Well, that's the
didn't get a good tip.
He got
better ones. He deserved time. Nothing.
But he wouldn't film with us.
He may have cost Angelo's a tag in this post.
Clean plate.
Yeah.
Main course is very good.
Main course was delicious.
I'm
and
to have anything I don't like.
Yeah. Nothing.
No, I'm right here with him.
Well,
that's definitely my son.
We all know you're not going
to
have any.
Those eggnog guys, man, I'm telling you. You got to watch those eggnog people.
Eggnog was good.
Eggnog people, you got to watch.
So we've got dessert, and then finishing it out with a special presentation.
Special treat for the end, but ooh, dessert's coming up.
Dessert's up next.
Hey.
Make sure you watch it to the end.
Well, we've got all our main course, our side dishes, our appetizers in, and it's time for dessert.
Ooh, yeah.
We've got three delicious desserts lined up from three iconic Christmas films. We have chocolate chip cookies from the Santa Claus. We have Twinkies from Die Hard.
That's right. Yeah. Die Hard is a Christmas movie.
Yeah. Amazing Christmas film.
Maybe the best.
And we have a Jell-O mold topped with cat food.
Oh, man.
Also from Christmas Vacation.
Milo wouldn't
Aunt Bethany,
food.
Man. Aunt Bethany.
So,
somewhere there's a cat in a package here.
Yeah, somewhere. Well, it's Schrodinger's cat in a package. Scott, you want to slice us up some Jell-O?
Yeah.
We'll get it passed out here before we get passed out.
Just never stop moving.
Food comas.
Don't Cosby me.
Well, it keeps jiggling. Your grandma?
My grandma's there.
Wait, what?
Exactly.
Oh,
that's gonna be tough.
Jell-O might be a problem.
Might have to get a little slide.
Yeah, I gotta wiggle while you jiggle, Scott.
Oh, there's one.
It never stopped moving from the minute it's been on that table.
It's alive.
Can't stop, won't stop.
It's jiggling like Tim Allen in the Santa Claus.
Good shot with the fork.
Oh, man.
It's jiggly.
That's the way Jell-O's supposed to be.
It's very kinetic.
J-E-L-L-O, it's alive.
Ooh. All right.
Making sure you didn't put cat food in this.
That's never. What it calls for, right?
Yeah, that's what the recipe said. Meow mix.
Oh, gel, yeah.
Meow.
Yeah.
See, I can slam gel.
I can't.
It's just there.
I'm so in between on it. Like, I don't
like it. I don't like it, but I don't hate it.
Yeah, it's just a thing that exists.
I'll be honest. That's where I'm at. A few months ago when I almost died, that was like one of the only things that I liked was Jell-O. Jell-O tasted real good to me at that point.
It's light. So. It's light.
It's light.
One more
it's
in the back.
I love Jell-O.
But I'm not about that. I don't know how I feel about
it.
That was perfect.
What I think is odd, the old from like the 70s, the Jell-O salads where they literally mixed Jell-O and vegetables and made... I think those are really weird. Strange. I've never had that, but I know it was a very common thing.
Have any of you ever had the thing, it's like Jell-O mixed with like pistachio stuff or marshmallow?
Like the Watergate salad.
Watergate salad.
Oh, no.
It's not just for Richard.
Hey, I am not a crook, dude.
We going?
Yeah.
Cat food with the crunch.
Tastes like Jell-O.
Oh, thank you.
And tastes like Jell-O, yes. Very much so.
That's maybe the most Jell-O-y Jell-O I've ever
tried. Not the Jell-Jell. Right.
That's
Jell-O. The Jell-O is floppy, floppy.
I love it.
I had a strawberry flavored Jell-O.
There's fruit inside of it.
The texture that the cat food adds.
Yep. Is that what you appreciate about it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, you toned it down about 15% there as far as size. Not bad. Yeah. I mean, it's Jell-O.
Can't confirm.
Yep. Well, we got our jellies.
Let's have a cookie.
Let's have a cookie.
A cookie for the tool man. Tim Allen almost went insane being Santa Claus in that movie. Did you know that?
Acting in a Christmas
movie. It really, really messed with him.
He's cursed.
I know Tim Allen also. I've
actually read that.
That's why the sequel didn't come out for like 6 years.
Yeah.
He also went to jail for selling cocaine.
He went too deep. He went full Santa.
He did. He
can't go full Santa.
He got too into it, and it really, it messed with him mentally. And the Santa suit apparently was hellacious, but it messed with him mentally, and it took a long time to do the sequel. And then they did part two, and it was solid. But part three is wonky.
Yeah, it's got Steve Martin. I gotta be honest. Dude, I like Steve Martin.
I kind of like part three.
Yeah. Cookies.
It's not Steve Martin.
Wait, is part three the one that's got Jack Frost?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I like that.
Dude.
I'm a fan of Martin Short.
I've never watched that one, but I always see
It's not Steve Martin, it's Martin Short.
Oh, yeah, my bad.
I think they're the same person.
The cheese is turned up way high, but I'm not complaining necessarily.
They got a new main elf. I don't like that. I like the curly-haired guy.
I do think that is a regret of it.
Who remembers Glick?
I remember Glick. Oh, yeah. Glick. Yeah.
Those are great cookies.
Yeah, good cookies.
I like them soft instead of
really good.
It's a chocolate chip cookie. I mean, you know what
I like them doughier. More like
soft batch.
Like a rare cookie. Instead of well done.
Salt batch is the best.
Cookies tartar.
Extra butter, I think.
What kind of psycho serial killers are eating hard, anyways?
Anyways. Yeah, so people
like chocolate chip cookie. No.
If it's chocolate chip,
give me salt.
Made for a duck. For like a duck and some milk.
No, it was a coffee.
A duck.
No, that does make sense.
Is there a yeti at the door? Is there a yeti at the door? No.
Is there an idiot at the door?
Possibly. Well, that's hateful. It's Christmas time.
Twinkies!
Yeah. Twinkies, John McClane, yippee-ki-yay.
Oh, wait.
Trucker.
Let's take Alan Friday. Rickman down.
He's already
down. Too far?
I can't do two.
What is the thing going on? Die Hard is a Harry Potter movie?
Yeah, it is.
There I am.
There's proof of this.
Taking Alan Rickman around in a dark tower.
Yeah.
We got these Twinkies, dog.
It's a banana, right?
These are just classic, banana flavored Twinkies. The old school classic.
This is my first Twinkie ever.
Whoa!
What?
What? I've never had Twinkies.
Wow!
I know.
Wow.
You like it?
Man, we might turn on you on that.
Kind of whatever.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't love a Twinkie. I don't fucking hate
a Twinkie. I got deep fried Twinkie.
It's just a funny reaction.
It's kind of whatever, really.
I've always heard Sides loves Twinks.
I do love Twinks.
I mean, it's okay.
It does.
I like that cream, though.
You're cream.
He's a cream man.
I'm more of a bear guy.
I like the bread.
But I mean,
bread's definitely a lever.
If you're stuck, the bread's too much. In 1988.
Just give me cream, hostess.
Nagatomi Tower.
Not a bag of cream.
Big facts.
This will be delicious.
Yeah,
big facts. This will be the best thing you've ever had in your life.
I mean, I like
you run around barefoot in glass.
Yeah.
I'm just kind of full, and it's a little heavy.
Yeah, we've been going hard. I mean,
dessert's been the most filling thing.
I gotta be honest, I'm getting real full too.
I am too.
And we still got
best Christmas dinner ever.
Yep, I'm determined to finish.
We've got probably the heaviest thing of all.
We don't end with dessert here.
No, it gets crazy.
1 to 10.
And that's it. We've got one segment left, all based around one film. My least favorite Christmas film.
Dude, I hate this film.
And I love it.
I love this film.
A very divisive film. You either love it or you hate it.
No, most
I think that's very
love.
True.
No, most people think it sucks.
I think most people do.
Yeah, you're right. I'm just trying to spread that seed. You hate it.
Yeah.
You hate it. Steve, join me. Join us.
Join us.
Join us.
The first half's really good. Just Zoe Deschanel.
Dude, she's fine.
You don't like her?
I don't like her. I don't like the stick.
See, I'm fine with her.
I don't care for it.
I mean, I love Will Ferrell, too. I hate this movie.
Wait, what movie are we talking about?
Elf.
We're talking about Elf. The last one. We have our Elf special up next.
Right, come on.
Well, we've made it this far.
We have.
And as our celebration of Elf, we have our spaghetti. Buddy's the Elf style. The guys here in the back, we've already got ours made up. The guys up front, they'll go ahead and make theirs so you can see what's going in it.
Marshmallows.
Got mini marshmallows there.
I don't see any possible good outcome here.
There's no not diabetes here.
No.
M&M's.
I do like M&M's.
See, I like everything in this mix. Together?
Yeah.
Come on.
I mean...
Noodles are cold as hell.
Yeah, we kind of made the noodles earlier and forgot about them.
Let's be honest, they might be grosser if they were hot.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah. You know what? You're right, actually. Probably.
Sprinkles.
Rainbow sprinkles.
I kind of like that.
Yeah.
Who in Hollywood is sick? This sick.
Jon Favreau, that's who I
said. Yeah.
I feel like Jon Favreau might eat this. Like, back when it was bigger.
This is the brain food for Baby Yoda.
Yes. And chocolate fudge Pop-Tarts.
Somebody just ordered.
Okay. And now for the sauces. Chocolate syrup.
Woo!
I really do like everything that's here.
Yeah.
But I don't know about together.
We're about to find out.
Sugar and carbs.
Yeah.
Sugar and carbs.
It has all the Elf food groups. We don't have any candy canes.
The most unhealthy dish ever. Is it?
But maybe.
Yeah.
Question mark.
We're opening the doors to our indigestion here.
And finally, pure maple syrup.
Oh, God.
Pure.
Yes. From Canada?
From Food Line.
Same thing.
Our Teddy Hart smuggled it down.
Oh.
Oh, mix that all.
Yeah, mix soup. It up. Soup.
Try to get a bite of everything.
Oh, boy.
Oh, my God.
So we got our front guys pouring. Matt's got his fork full ready to go.
Oh, my goodness.
I got this. Oh, it's really making me nervous. And I'm a guy that eats stupid stuff.
Yeah.
That you do.
Like, you would make this a Golden Corral.
Yeah.
I'd have to be under the influence of a...
of Golden Corral.
Of Golden Corral, yeah.
Of Chocolate Fountain.
Oh, yeah, we're good.
All right, guys. Bone apple tea.
I've literally got a little bit of everything on this spoon, on this fork right now. Weird. The M&M's are like a nice little mix there in the mouth. Then the noodle just jumped in there.
Oh. Yeah.
The fact that the noodles are cold does not make it better.
No.
It makes it so much worse. It's not good.
No, actually, my throat's rejecting it.
Oh, yeah.
I can't get it.
Dude, I'm trying to get it down.
This is really bad.
I gotta make it a pace to get it down.
My throat's rejecting it, too.
Oh, God, that was hard.
Bite cleared.
Oh, dude.
But barely.
Barely, dude. Like,
I am not going back in.
Ew.
Oh!
God. That finish.
There's a piece left.
That finish.
Oh. There's a tiny piece left.
I want to fall.
The aftertaste isn't pleasant.
The noodles are so rubbery where they've sat for so long.
Yeah.
And this,
it's in my throat.
And that chocolate is really coated in with it.
Dude, that...
I went from enjoying it right up to the top of the belch meter. Right there.
That's rough. If anyone's ever thought of trying this and
don't.
It's not worth it.
It's not even the taste. It's just that noodle texture.
Yeah, oh, I think you're right. The noodles are really making me.
They don't have a taste.
Each bite tastes like it's a gag reflex.
It gets harder to chew as it goes.
It's like it's like sweets with intestine.
Yeah, I'm trying to pick out the good stuff.
But yeah, I can agree on
there
that.
There is good stuff in there.
If you just pick out an M&M or just pick out a piece of Pop Tart.
But then I can't quit thinking about it.
Oh, God, there's a little noodle on there.
The noodles are what killed us.
It was weird.
Well, did anybody like it, Brayden? You a fan?
No.
Just like the movie Elf, garbage.
Oh,
I can agree with that. I concur.
But
that's soupy.
We have it's so soupy.
Belch meter.
Look at that. That mine's real.
I'm picking up the
M&M's. Oh, my God.
Oh, the M&M's are getting picked up.
All right.
God, I'm telling you.
But they're not finished.
No, we have one redeeming elf quad thing from Elf left, so it could turn things around as far as elf goes.
I don't think it's going to be too redeeming.
I doubt it.
But
we've got the Buddy the Elf soda chug.
Soda chug.
There's only a few of us that are brave enough to do this one.
I think we've got three takers, right?
Matt, do all the pops in this room have protectors? Cover? In case there's a spew.
Oh, everything needs protected. All right, here we go.
Put out the tarps.
We're coming back.
All right, we're going to split up a little bit and get these three. All right, we are on to the drinks of Elf. As you've seen in the movie Elf, Buddy the Elf chugs a 2 liter of Coca-Cola Classic down in no time flat. So tonight we have our arson contestants going to see if they can chug down 2 liters of their respective colas. Ninja rocking the Diet Coke, Matt with the Coca-Cola Classic, and Scott with the seltzer water. I've got me a cup of coffee, just like Buddy has in the film. And
is there syrup?
No. Bad. Coffee's bad. But you know what makes coffee good? Just like Buddy's coffee in the mailroom.
There it is.
Oh, syrup. Coffee.
Go with the flow. Or get out of the flow.
So, I'm going to step aside out of the splash zone.
Yeah.
And, gentlemen, would you like to uncork your drinks?
These are warm. I will say.
Yeah, our spaghetti's cold, but our sodas are warm.
Not a good combination. I am standing. I know Buddy was seated in the film, but...
Alright, everybody standing up. And,
this is literally
Get a countdown going
not
here.
A good idea. No, I don't even know what's going to happen.
5, 4, 3, 2, chug! Oh, Matt's down with not quite a quarter. Nathan got down to the label.
Oh my goodness, that's so right on. Look at this guy.
And Scott, a little bit over halfway.
About half.
None of you are true elves.
Well, I am not. That literally, as I was chugging, if you were right here, you could just hear. I heard doing stuff. The stones were just like. Woo! Woo!
Well.
Props. I mean. They faked it for the movie.
Yeah, I think Will Ferrell did it for real.
He did not. He did not. They had a hose. It's a movie fact for you. Matt Facts.
Matt Facts!
There was a hose running along the side of the 2-liter in the movie. And the burp was recorded by, I forget the actor's name.
It wasn't me. That mama girl.
That was pretty solid.
Yeah, they had a good effort.
All right, so pretty much an epic fail all around. All Scott the being elves. The... I won't say the winner, because I don't know.
Yeah, it's,
that was tough. I was least. That's all I could do.
It wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be.
Yeah,
I don't know. It was about what I thought. If it hadn't been cold, I think I could have got maybe down to the label a little past, but not much more. Mm-hmm. All right. Moving back to you.
Well, thank you for watching the food portion of North Pole Eats. And like every good arson special, though, we gotta finish with a song.
We have to.
So let's gather the family around for a good old Christmas carol.
Go, Mark, go. Need some bootleggers and a little
bag of something and we'll be alright. A box of beer and some Camel Lights. Hallelujah, everybody say cheese. Merry Christmas from the A.B.'s. Feliz Navidad. Thank you for watching North Pole Eats. Please check us out. Subscribe to our YouTube channel right here, the Arson Brothers Network. Look for us on Facebook under Arson Brothers, Instagram, Twitter, all social media. Please check us out. We hope you've enjoyed North Pole Eats.